What led you to the swimming hall?
Will said there was something important in his briefcase. All I found was a key with Bradbury Swimming Hall on the chain. Only lead we had.
I guess this is it.
This building's been shut down for years.
Perfect place to hide something you don't want found.
I think it's time you tell me what you know.
I know your brother built the one thing that can stop the fracture. I know we're meant to find it, and I know Monarch doesn't want us to.
And yet you're wearing their uniform.
I like the way their pants fit.
Yeah, I bet you like the paycheck, too.
Tried to create a cover to gather information. You've known about this for a few hours. I've been preparing for it for most of my life.
You weren't aware that William owned the place?
There's a lot I didn't know about Will.
We need to find your brother's countermeasure. And fast. Things will get worse as the fracture progresses. And Monarch will be turning Riverport over looking for you.
Will's key. Maybe it unlocks this. Key doesn't fit. Okay. I'm gonna find another way in.
Make it quick. I'll keep a lookout for unwanted company.
This is weird. Huh. I could swear this is the same cab I was in when I came to the university.
It's a taxi. They all look the same, don't they? I'll check the license plate on my phone and see if anything comes up, but it's a long shot.
Hey, I think I found a way in.
Whoa. Hey, I just looked up the license plate of the cab parked over there. It belongs to somebody named Nick Marsters. Nick Marsters? That's the name of one of the witnesses who picked up in the university.
Damn it. These stutters aren't going away.
Will had used the building to hide away his personal items.
What the hell were you doing here, brother? Time travel experiments with rats?
$12,000 moving bill. He must have hauled a lot more to this place than just some old boxes.
Okay, May 17th, 1998. This is William Joyce, and I'm about to conduct
you
the
owned
first
this place since
test of the machine
1999?
Using my trusty pet mouse.
Why didn't you tell me?
He's gone. Where'd he go? Shit. Come on, Schrodinger.
No wonder you are always coming up with crazy shit.
Come on, you're okay. You're all right. Okay, finally, we're sending Schrodinger into the machine.
Hello, Riverport. Teresa Sedmak here, filling in for Bobby Radford. About to brighten your day with some good news. The victims wounded during the terrorist
attack. Any luck in there?
Working on it.
All right, let's take a look around. Down here.
Nice work.
This note. It's directed at me.
July 4th, 2010. Beth Wilder, I'm addressing this video to you. You told me to stay away from my workshop, but I couldn't just leave it there. I went back to get it, and the entire place is a disaster zone. The countermeasure, gone, taken.
Shit. What the?
Safe, empty. I just need to know you have it, because if it falls into the wrong hands, its power is immeasurable. Our future, our entire lives depend on it. This can't all be for nothing. You know where to find me. Please, hurry.
2010.
July 4th.
Holy shit.
Beth Wilder.
What was that?
You recorded that for me in 2010?
I couldn't just leave it there.
What the fuck?
I went back to get it. And the entire place.
So the countermeasure's gone?
The countermeasure, gone.
It's not good.
Oh, shit.
We need to figure this out.
Safe.
Let's keep looking.
Empty. I just need to know you have it. Because if it falls into the wrong hands, its power is immeasurable. Our future.
Help me push this out of the way.
Our entire lives depend on it. This can't all be for nothing. You know where to find me. Please, hurry.
Jack, your brother addressed that video to me. But I've never met him before in my life.
Well, it sounded like he thought you had his countermeasure.
I wish. But he said it was stolen on July 4th, 2010. Somebody took it. But I'm hoping this place will help us figure out who. I'll give you the honor of pressing the button. Is that?
Yeah, I think so. The second time machine. This changes everything. If we can get this thing working, then we don't need that countermeasure. We can change everything. What if we stop the fracture from ever happening in the first place? We can go back to yesterday, undo everything in the past before it happens. Nobody dies. Paul doesn't go through the machine. Monarch never exists. I mean, the fracture never occurs.
Jack, wait. Let's think this through. That's not how it...
I can go into the machine like Paul did at the university. I helped them set it up. Then we activate the core, put the corridor in place, and set the date. I can do it, Beth.
I'm not so sure we can do this without the countermeasure. But you're right. We'll need the machine.
Right. Let's start with the core.
Explanation? Anybody?
I saw some kind of visions of this machine in his workshop. You must have hit it here.
Feel free to fill me in. Anytime now.
Okay, core controls. Where are they? Hey, Amy.
What is this?
I don't think you believe me.
In the past 2 hours, I've learned that Monarch is a secret paramilitary.
It's a time machine.
Okay. I'll compartmentalize that with everything else that shouldn't make sense.
We should help Jack find the core controls.
Yeah. Okay.
You said Will built a countermeasure. What makes you so sure this isn't it? The time machine.
He said the countermeasure was stolen. But the machine is still here.
This is gonna work. It has to.
You guys aren't actually planning to use this machine. Are you? So, I guess you're not at all concerned that one guy jerry-rigged this entire thing together? Because I think I literally see duct tape. Okay, no, this is a great idea. Yeah, no way that this is gonna backfire.
It says the time machine core needs to be reset.
Great. What the hell's it look like?
A round thing in the middle, I think. I can't activate the core till it's reset.
Hey, Jack. You might want to check out this monitor. None of these consoles even look like they're from the 21st century.
Hey, it looks like I can reset the core from here.
Are you sure you know what you're doing there?
No clue. But I did help Paul set up the machine at the university.
Which then caused the fracture.
Look, Will knew the calculations were wrong. Hoping that means he knew what he was doing here. This is what Will leads to. We have to test it. The core. That's what we set up first.
This could actually be the key to finding the countermeasure.
We'll see. It's still resetting. The core is... Here goes nothing. Worked. Okay, we activate the corridor next.
Okay, there is
can't
no
insert
way
the date
that
yet.
Thing should be exposed like that.
This was the final step. I need to set up the machine first. This is gonna work. It has to.
You guys aren't actually planning to use this machine, are you? So, I guess you're not at all concerned that one guy jerry-rigged this in...
The corridor. It's key activated.
Will's key.
Thank God.
Is that supposed to do that?
Will's key did that?
Yeah.
Key to a time machine, and he left it in a trunk of his goddamn car.
That's my brother in a nutshell. No, nothing I can make sense of.
That doesn't sound good.
Fuck. Let's just hope it still works. Damn it. I don't know. We were so close. I'm gonna try it again.
Yeah, like hell you are. You saw what happened. Something's wrong with the machine.
We don't know that.
You're not trained for this. Anything you do is gonna make it worse.
We
you
can't.
Know I'm right.
Stop trying.
You lost people. You're angry. I get it. But this is bigger than us. We can't fix the machine. But I might know somebody who can. Sophia Amaral.
The Monarch scientist. I saw her video near Ground Zero.
Serene's had a crone in research. She'll be at the Monarch Gala tonight, but security's airtight. She'll be nearly impossible to get to.
Unless I have an invite. Paul told me he expected me to meet him at that party.
Something tells me that was not a friendly invitation. Jack, no.
but I'm half back.